welcome to Bollywoodwallah. I am Sunup. I am here with the absolutely fabulous Nisha Jamvwal. Nisha ji, thank you very much for talking to me. It's such a delight to see you. So vibrant, so positive.
Thank you.
And
so
I love the smile that you sport all the time whenever we meet. First things first, columnist, interior designer, actor, you're a fashionista. How do you juggle so many different avatars with absolute ease?
So I believe that life is to be lived to the lees, as Tennyson said. And I think if you look at some creative minds, they are restless. So you have to, like yourself, you have to do what your heart desires. You have one life and you have to epitomize all the things that, you know, you've learned and you've loved and all your passion to their hit.
Right. You know, you've had such a fabulous journey. You know, if I may ask you to rewind a bit, how did it all start? You've faced many challenges as well, but you've surmounted them with great ease. So what keeps you going? What is the mantra in your life that you follow? You're a life coach yourself as well. So what is your mantra for yourself?
So my mantra is, to a large extent, never give in.
Okay.
And it's also been to stay positive. Mm. So whatever happens, even in the not so happy phases, I look for the triumph and the lesson. I look for the inspiration. And I also always know that somewhere some people are getting motivated and inspired by my challenges. What keeps me going is I often take breaks and I travel.
Okay.
So I feel that gives me a lot of chutzpah and energy. Okay. So I consciously break my work periods with holidays to Switzerland, to
Whoa.
Japan,
okay.
to remote villages in Europe, very much like 100-foot journey.
Okay.
And the other thing that keeps me going is the indomitable spirit of India.
Uh-huh.
You know, India has been knocked around, ill-treated, colonized. But when you look at the Ganpati festival and you look at these poor people dancing with so much happiness, and you look at the landed people getting up every morning with aches and pains and problems,
mm-hmm.
I think there's a lesson there.
Absolutely. And
the lesson
right.
is to overcome, triumph and enjoy life and live every minute to a beautiful value of that minute.
I'm sure your upcoming television chat show will also bring to fore all these different inspirational qualities.
Yes,
from
but in other people's perspectives.
Right, right. I was coming
yes,
to that.
Yes.
In other people's personalities that you're going to interview. So tell me, how did you conceive this show to begin with? How did this entire thing fall into place?
So I actually have always been a writer, writing
right.
many columns. And the columns have this, but in a different medium, which
yes.
is writing. So I also had 3 very successful television shows which started on 2 repeats but went to 5 repeats prime time.
Right.
So they were very well received and I was very much younger then.
Right.
So I feel now with a myriad experiences and more friends in the milieu of film, television, cricket, politics, I feel I would be much more efficacious in drawing out people.
Absolutely, and I have no doubt about the same. Tell me, what are the different kind of personalities that we'll get to see on the show, and what is the format of the show, if you could just tell our audience?
So at the moment, we are ideating on various shows. There
okay.
are travel, there's a travel show, there's a design and interior show, because professionally I've trained to be an interiors architect.
Uh-huh.
But there's also a show on you know, a slice of life chat conversational show
right.
Where you will see what you mentioned, you know, bringing out people, bringing out their challenges, bringing out various you know, the ups and downs of life
right.
What are the personalities I intend to meet and talk to would be the people I sit in you know I mean jinke saath uthna baithna hai, and they are all you know, cricketers, politicians, artists. I'm a collector of
okay.
contemporary Indian art,
okay.
and Bollywood stars, you know, even character actors. I think everyone has a story, and everyone's story is an inspiration.
You know, Bollywood and cricket are considered to be 2 of the foremost religions of India, right? If I were to ask you to pick one personality from each of these different fields for your chat show, who would that be? Who tops your list?
In Bollywood?
In Bollywood.
in Bollywood.
Who would make for an inspiring personality on a show?
I find all of them so interesting,
right.
But if you were to ask me to pick one,
uh-huh.
I feel a great, what's the word I'm looking for? I feel a kindred spirit in Karan Johar.
Oh, okay.
Because he's one of the people who's lived all his dreams.
Correct.
He wrote a book, he's doing a chat show, he's acting, he's directing, he's producing. So he, like me, believes in sucking life
oh.
of all its juices.
Right.
And triumphing.
Right.
So I find him interesting. I've already interviewed him 3-4 times, but
uh-huh.
I associate with him.
Correct.
I associate. The second
correct.
Person I find very interesting is somebody I've seen when I was very young. He was a football star in St. Columbus School,
uh-huh.
And he was a theater actor. He worked with DAG. And then he went
oh.
on to do.
Okay.
He went on to do
the Great Shark.
The Great Shark.
Dag.
I've seen him, and I did the sets. I did the set design for Raju Bandhya Gentleman. I was
Whoa.
A little girl.
Whoa.
I was a little teenager,
uh-huh.
and I did the sets for Brick Boss and Raju.
Wow.
Yeah.
Great.
And I've seen him since then, and I find him very interesting because quintessentially he's not a good-looking man.
Okay.
But what he has is that joie de vivre. That you need in the entertainment industry.
Right.
It's a myth that you need to have looks.
Oh,
you need
okay.
to have chutzpah and you need to have killer instinct. And
wow.
he has it.
Wow.
And whatever you say, if you look at him in Dear Zindagi or Chak De, he's a brilliant actor.
Absolutely. And he had that charisma even when he did.
And he's got the right amount of self-worth. It's true he doesn't like over-critical people, but I respect and admire that. He's doing his best, and I don't think people should really go after him. He's an out-and-out success, and we need to be very proud of him.
Absolutely,
can
absolutely. And you handled it so brilliantly well, Ellen. We should learn from you.
Yeah, it started.
Let's start?
Yeah.
Okay. You know, you've traveled the world. You're so well-traveled. Tell me any international personalities that you find particularly inspiring and who you would perhaps want to have on your show to have a chat with.
I don't know, having, yes, actually, why not? One of the people I find most exciting is Lord Jeffrey Archer, the author,
okay.
who's also, as you know, written my own story.
Absolutely.
And I know you're going to ask me about it.
Right.
But the reason I find him interesting is, and I'm going to say something politically incorrect, I met Wilbur Smith. Wilbur Smith is one of my favorite authors. And when I met him, it was like water being poured on me. It was so flat and so unexciting that I really felt that maybe one shouldn't meet the artist behind the art. And when I met Jeffrey Archer, he has enhanced his books to 100%. You know, he's so exciting, so funny, so humorous, so naughty, he's full of shaitani. And he takes his books from here to here, just
wow.
with his personality.
Absolutely.
He's 75 and he would put all our energy to shame.
Right.
He's exciting, he's funny, he's well informed, he loves Indian cricket and he loves Bollywood.
Amazing. And how did he fall in love with your story? Did it come as a surprise to you?
No, actually, I have to correct you. He fell in love with me.
Okay. My mistake, he fell in love with you. Okay. Go ahead, Nisha.
Okay, I'm teasing. So,
okay.
Yes, he was very fond of me and
okay.
he asked me very casually and I told him my story. I told him just a bit or two.
Okay.
And as the evening went forward, he unraveled a few more secrets about my life.
Okay.
And before I knew it, there was a story. And
wow.
before I knew it, it was May the 2nd, which is my birthday.
Uh-huh.
And he flew down to India. And he gave me the first copy. I must get you a copy.
Right.
He gave me a first copy and he said, read it. And I said, I'm too scared to read my own story. So he read it to me. We were sitting
wow.
At one of my favorite restaurants. It's a rooftop restaurant called Souk.
Right.
And I tell you, I just had tears in my eyes because it's a happy and a poignant story.
Correct, absolutely.
So it was one of the most memorable moments of my life.
Mm, I'm pretty sure about that.
Yes.
You know, now we know that a movie is being made. It's a biopic.
And I love Hugh Grant.
Oh.
I would love to. I mean, I just love the man.
Okay.
I would love to interview him.
Oh, okay.
And I don't know if David Suchet is alive. He plays Hercule Poirot in all the Agatha Christie remakes.
Okay.
I love David Suchet. So, yes, I would love to interview David Suchet.
Right.
And there are so many international politicians who I admire, Angela Merkel being one of them. I think she's a very strong, powerful woman. And in this day and age, I think we all want to interview Kim Jong, who's creating such a stir. And, you know, I feel like every cup of coffee I'm having is the last cup of coffee. A hydrogen bomb is going to fall any minute. So, yeah.
From Korea. But, yeah, if we can get in, that would be like the icing on the cake, I'm pretty sure. You know, coming to the movie bit, I heard a movie is being made. It's a biopic of sorts. So, how is it going to shape up? If you could just tell my viewers.
So, I'm sitting here at the production house. Right. We're all ideating. Directors are being shortlisted. Actors are being shortlisted.
Right.
It has to be a true-to-life story, inspirational, motivational. We are living in a very changing time in India. Mm. Women playing different roles of pilots, chefs. I feel if my story could inspire women who see the end of the road in their lives and achieve some degree of chutzpah in their life through my story, it would be a triumph for me.
But I'm sure it will be a movie that stands for women empowerment. You know, any first choices that you have in mind as far as actresses go? So
I think that would be predominantly the decision of the director. But if you were to just ask me for the sake of, you know, fun, I would off the cuff immediately think of Deepika Padukone because she's laid out her life. She's, no holds barred. She's shared with her viewers her deepest secret. And she doesn't look weak. She only looks stronger and more triumphant after that.
Absolutely.
So I really love her sense of joie de vivre and her sense of love of life. And also the way she lives her life. It's not a hypocrisy.
Yeah. We hope that really happens with Deepika Padukone.
I love her, yes. But I also love Pariniti Chopra and Sushmita Sen. They are two very, very favorite human beings, friends and actors. I love them.
Brilliant.
And I actually really like Deepika. I get along famously.
And in actors, who would be your choices?
Well, I already spoke to Amir Khan.
Ah, okay.
And he asked me to send him the book, which I did.
Okay.
But it would depend on the director because Amir is also a person who never has dates.
Okay.
But he is the sensitive person who would play the love angle.
Right, absolutely. And who is directing it?
We are still sitting and ideating on that. That's a very core and that's the most, in my book, in a film, the most important person is the director.
Right, okay. You were recently awarded at the Savvy's, great event with the Women's Achievers Award, if I'm not mistaken. How privileged and proud do you feel when big magazines like these recognize your achievements and your...
I feel, earlier this year, I received the Femina World Women's Achievers Award, which was very big for me.
Okay.
Because it was an international award.
Mm-hmm.
There were leaders from South Africa, from Nairobi, from England, from Japan. There were world leaders.
Mm.
And I was rewarded and awarded for my work in CSR and luxury. And I felt very honored and fortunate, not only because of the work they were awarding me for, but also the milieu I was in. The people, the women they had picked up were women from all over the world.
Mm.
Dr. Raju Bhatia awarded me my award, and the plaque he gave me enlisted all my achievements.
Amazing.
So it was a very special moment for me.
Right. You know, there is one thing which before I end that I would really like to know. We love your red carpet looks. You're such a fashionista. So before we close this show, a few tips from your end on how to look your best at such great events.
Thank you so much for the compliment. I really enjoyed
chatting.
You've been one of the most fun people to chat with. So full of life.
Okay.
And the other thing I want to tell you is the truth. I don't want to, not tell you the truth.
Okay.
The fact is I've always gone with my heart, be it my career, be it my dress sense.
Uh-huh.
I've never played by the book. And I've never looked at trends.
Mm-hmm.
And I've never looked at honest and valuable criticism too dedicatedly.
Okay.
I've gone with my heart.
Okay.
So while I appreciate and I accept criticism, I know I'm an OTT person.
Okay.
I've worn hats when we didn't need to wear hats. I love hats. I have a huge collection.
Uh-huh.
I want gowns because I love gowns. Sometimes it works to make magic.
Uh-huh.
Sometimes it's viewed as a bit much.
Uh-huh.
But do I really care? So long as I know I'm not inappropriate,
mm-hmm.
and so long as I know that I'm not offending anyone's sensibilities or value systems,
mm-hmm.
I'm very happy to, you know, wear what makes me, fun and bling and make me feel my best. And what is my ultimate style tip to every woman,
right.
is wear your confidence,
mm-hmm.
and wear your life experiences with panache. The clothes just follow.
Wow, absolutely. That is such a great line to end our show with. But so lovely talking to you, Nisha, and wish you all the very best.
Had a beautiful chat.
Thank you so much, and wish you all the very best for your chat show as well as for your
thank
show.
You.
Thank you. Thank you. This is Sonam signing off, but keep tuned to my channel Bollywoodwallah for more news, debates, discussions, interviews and updates from the world of Bollywood. Bye.
Thanks,
thank you, Nisha. So much fun talking to you.
So much fun. I'm still laughing.
It was really nice one.
Thank you.